Hey, hello, welcome back to my channel. Going to turn my reverse my jaws around so that I can grab onto this larger diameter. Pretty simple operation. Okay, we're ready to set this in here. And I have some copper shims to put in here. Okay, one more up here. Okay, we'll get a hand, we'll get a soft blow and knock that in, then we're going to get a test indicator on there and check that run out on the face. Okay, let's see if we can wash this. Get the glare out of there. So we might be a thousandth out there on the face. But we're not going to sweat that. Okay. So what we need to do here is first we need to get this out of the way. And this is what we're looking at. We got this, we got index on this. This is where the Kondia head indexes. This is where the south bend indexes with the tilt gear. Okay. The relief cutouts will be on this side, going up against the Kondia head, which would be sucking it towards and South Bend. So we get these features turned, then we'll put this back on the machine, get the machine operating, do the drilling and tapping in the through holes here, and then machining our reliefs for our nuts, and I think we'll be in pretty good condition. Providing all my transfer information rings true. Tighten this up, make sure it's not going to go anywhere. I'll get the indicator on here and double check that. Since we moved it around so much. So, we'll bring this back around here to zero. Just give this a spin. Light up my screen. Yeah, looks like we added at least a thousandths run out, tightening that up. I'm still gonna be okay with that. So I'll go ahead and get a boring bar set up, and we'll get on these measurements and get this cut out. Okay, bring you back when something else is happening. In the position of the first shoulder. So I need to measure that, mark that, and adjust it, because I'm only going in. So my depth of cut on this first is 423 thousandths, and the diameter is 4.438. So we're cutting out to 4.438 at the previous depth mentioned. Okay, so we'll bring you back when we start making chips. And let me go in a little bit about the video that I lost. Because man, you know, it was a total failure with some lessons. So here's the milling head. Okay, and it mounts there. So here is my jack, or my hoist. Now, when I took the headstock off the lathe, I took these outriggers, and I did not deploy them. I hung a piece of square bar inside of them, hooked up a chain fall, and I tied that to a 4-stroke Wisconsin motor, and that counterweight was able to lift the headstock off the lathe. Well, now here I am with this thing suspended. I got one bolt left holding it in, and about a 6-inch drop if it should fail. So I thought, okay, I'll lower the quill until I get the quill sitting inside the vise. So if the system does fail, the head's not going to tumble to the floor. It's going to stand up on the vise. And that's what happened. So I added some weight to the motor and the platform. Ended up bringing the outriggers out. And I'm able to get a good lift of that head. I currently have it resting on the bed so that in case my hydraulic cylinder has any leak down. So, yeah. It was a good video. I'm damn sorry I lost it. I was trying to hold it for a while, and apparently I need to have the SD card in the computer. I thought when I downloaded it to my computer, it was in my computer, independent of the memory card. In other words, you download it to your hard drive, it should be on your hard drive in totality and not have to rely on... I don't know, I have other videos that behave that way, so I'm not sure what I did. I'm sure it's my fault. But I feel good finally getting this together. So we'll bring you back when we start flying some shit. Okay, I have my depth set for 410 thousandths. I'm going to do a diameter of 4.530, and at which point I'll work on the other surface and it'll be 3 inches. So we're going to go at 314. Let's try 190 RPMs.
increase my feed rate a little bit. I'm gonna go from 6 to 10. Sounding anything like that. Let me take a look at my tip, my cutting tool. Thank you. tip looks fine. So let's come back over here. Getting a nice hot chip coming off of there. We'll do 100,000ths this time. Looks like we're close to 100,000ths. So I'm gonna take 50. Copies of my original plate made, their actual size. So I got some copies of my original plate made, their actual size. So then we're gonna do 50,000ths. Our feet. here's a rough number here. $289. So one is 90, 11 thousandths. I think this is going to be the final pass. Cut the feed rate in half. Change the feed direction here.
measure this. Let's see what we got. I'm going to do one more little pass. That's it for the lathe work. We'll reassemble the mill with the existing adapter plate. We'll drill and tap our half 13s and then our 3/8, 3/16, whatever the size is, the through hole drill for that. And then we'll fly cut our clearances to get our wrench in there to tighten up on the T-nuts. And then we will remove the head once more, replace the old plate with the new plate, and reattach that for the final time. So, long days and pleasant nights. We'll see you next time. I hope you'll follow along.